On kolumuzni köksümüzde tutan halde. Азер, бах, будет праздник у вас. Нөбетте, дүния уйгур кулзейнің рейси, Долкын Иса апендімне сөзге тәкліп кылмен.
Ассаламу алейкум, әзіз ватандашларым, дүнияның һәр қайсы елдерден келген, әзіз жәңчілер, хош келдіңла. Бүгін Еуропаның мәркізіге, дүнияның сияси мәркездердің бір болған Европа комиссиясының алдыға бүгін жиылып, біз яңғыз авазымызды дүнияға ұмытшамыз, бәлкі өз халқымызға мәдәт беріш. Тұрмыла етіп атқан 1 миллион артық инсанымызға, «Хей, сіла бәке етіп атмадыңла, оқыңлады біз ба, біз сіланың перзентіңла, сіланың ұт яттан жапалырыңланы, тәп атқан азабыңланы, біз жүргімізілен ескотымыз». Деген бұ авазымызды халқымызге yollash үшін беді. Шының ұлан бірге, біз беді, Қытай үкіметіге, сән қанчылық залым болсаң мұ, қанчылық қысасқор болсаң мұ, қанчылық вәші болсаң мұ, амма біздің халқымыздың әркілікке, өрлікке, озаттықы болған интелішдіріне, арзулырыне, жоқ қыланмайсан деген сигналыне, Қытай үкіметіне беріш үшін біледі. Біз бүгін еді біледі Еуропа комиссияға 28 дәулетке Бірлескен дәулетлер тәшкілатыға дүния рәхбәрлерге әй құлығыңында тықуанма ай әді 1 миллион инсан насик кампыларда насик кампыларда жоқ ұлыш қырлыш алды тұрватыды бұл бір инсанлық жинайет бұныңға дәсту дейі үшін біледі. Шыныңға бүгінгі бұл намайшымыздың әхмейті әр қанда бір вақыт кеден, әр қанда бір вақыт кеден бұйым, әмменлердің қадымығы көп рәхмет, бәді қанақыра мәтбуатуа, чәтәлік лава, мән сөзімні әңгілісі давам қаймен. Ladies and gentlemen, dear my countrymen, honorable guests, thank you all for coming from all over the Europe and the rest of the world. World Uyghur Congress and Preparation Committee and Unrepresent People's and Nation Organization. Thank you for showing your strong and visible support today. The size of crowd here today is clear sign the Uyghur community in Europe is tired of such a weak response from the European Union. We are tired of the international community paying attention all the situation and the conflict around the world, the political continent. We are tired of the lack solidarity between states who continue not to challenge Chinese government to fear of retaliation. We are tired of absolute lack of humanity for millions who are suffering on conditions we are almost impossible to believe. We are tired of watching with our own eyes as our family and friends slip away from us. China knows Europe can be divided. It pushes hard enough without a response. We are here today to show that we are in desperate need of response. Many of us here watched over an entire lifetime what has happened to our homeland in Turkestan. Uyghur identity has been purposely eroded by Chinese government. Our language, our culture, our religion, our way on the line. Uyghur has been directly associated by terrorism. Uyghur have been locked up for the perpetrated crimes. Uyghur are not able to move free even in Turkestan. Uyghur has been killed by the police security forces. We have watched how the rest of the world has really reacted to the response of the Uyghur here. There has been no response in Europe. There is no response in the Muslim world. There is not to be adequate response from United Nations and the European Union. A direct result of the lack response of this problem has been a Chinese government able to do anything it wants. That's why we are gathered here today. At least 1 million Uyghurs are detained in so-called re-education camp across East Turkestan. 1 million people is an extraordinary number that is difficult to accept for some. But we all know firsthand that our family members, friends, as I speak, they have no time to wait anymore. In our job to show international community exactly what is happening. No one else will do this for us. We are only ones who can continue European Union, United Nations, country around the world to act. To European Union, we know you are feel pressure from China on trade and economic issue. We need to tell you that our family member feel direct pressure for the Chinese government every day. This is not abstract. Thousands of Uyghurs live in European Union. Europe has responsibility to protect these people from Chinese government who are punishing our family simply for living here. European Union has written recognized responsibility to take real step into the foreign policy effort to ensure that human rights all people in priority. To Chinese government, we know you are listening. We are now you are threatened by us. We know Chinese Communist Party is fragilizing. You have to choose today. You can choose to keep doing what you are doing, or you can choose inclusivity. The path you are taking today is not suitable. It will fail in the end. We almost speak unison in response to what Chinese are doing to Uyghur people. This is the only way that real change can be happen. We will protest here today to show how serious we are, but the protest does not end today. This is just the beginning. We will only stop when real action has been taken and we see real change on the ground in Turkestan. European Union must speak up. European Union must speak up for the Uyghur. Speak up for the justice. Being Uyghur is not a crime. World needs to act. The world needs to speak before it gets worse. Thank you for your attention.
Долкун Айсаға, Дүния Уйғыр Құлтайының рәйесі Долкун Айсаға көп рахмет. Нөбәтте мушу бучу намайшнинки уйштурылышыда бізге көп ярдамды болған вакалетсіз милләтлер тешкілатынынки мәсғули Лучия ханымны сөзге тәкліп кініме. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you all for coming today to participate in the Uyghur March for Freedom. I know that many of you have traveled long distances to attend this march. It is wonderful to see so many of you here today. I would like also to thank the World Uyghur Congress, the unrepresented nations and people's organization, and all the Uyghur organizations across the Europe that worked so hard to make this protest happen. Now I would like to invite Ms. Lucia from UNPO. Lucia Khan.
We want freedom! What do we want? So, dear colleagues and friends, dear fellow Europeans, but most of all, dear Uyghurs, all of you that came from all over the world today to speak up as one voice and to denounce the atrocities committed against your people. I thank you all for having gathered here today in defense of human rights and dignity, for the two most basic principles that hold us together. As you know, I'm here on behalf of the UNPO. We have been around the world for 25 years to work relentlessly to open a space in international community for actors traditionally excluded from the public debate. Among those actors, the Uyghurs, one of our founding members, has always been an example of how solidarity can work as a bond capable of overcoming the most atrocious crimes. Their struggle shows us how the rights of minorities suffering from the cruelest forms of discrimination must become a priority for all the international actors working to defend of human rights. Recent events in China have taught us in the most inhuman way that statements are simply not enough. During the last months, it has been revealed that the Chinese government has taken the campaigning of terror and repression exercised against the Uyghur community beyond our worst nightmares. The network of re-education camps designed and implemented by Xi Jinping administration has condemned more than a million people, women, children, entire families, to the worst possibly imagined living conditions. The level of repression achieved by this new strategy is a direct violation not only of the Chinese legacy, but also the most fundamental principles found in international law. For decades, we know that China sees a direct threat simply for the existence of the Uyghur community.